Good morning students, let us start our today's class with the new topic binary arithmetic operators. Maybe some of you will ask that there was one topic shorthand operators which I had missed, but I think I had taught this in the last video lecture of class of chapter 3. If you are having any problem, you can ask in the live classes also, but I'll give you a small glimpse over there of that. If a plus b like this is written, if a equals to a plus b like this is written, so the short form of this a plus is equals to b, you can write, okay? Or suppose b is equals to b into c is there, then in that case b into equals to c, you can use this one. Okay, so this is the use of shorthand operators, and whatever the examples are given in the book, you have to solve by your own, and the method is same what I had explained in the previous video lecture. Now in today's video lecture, we'll discuss about our next topic, that is binary arithmetic operator. In unary operator, what we are doing, we are performing operation on only one operand. Here we are having more than one operand, means two operand. Binary means two, and we have to perform operations on that one. Suppose you are given a plus b, so this and this are operands, and this is the operator which we are using in between of these two. Clear? So whenever we are performing any calculation, any division, any multiplication, any mod on two operands, then we say that binary arithmetic operator come into existence. Okay, suppose we have to make one simple program for that, then what we will do and how we will make? Simply you just do make a class division. Okay, then in that one we have to use PSVM, the short form of public static void main. Okay, you can use here string args, because you were taught this thing in class 8, so you can use this thing also. Next, here I have taken one data type int, and if a equals to 10, comma b equals to 2, and there is one c in which nothing is stored, that means 0. Now c is equals to a upon b, that means a is going to be divided by b. Then after that, system dot out dot print ln, and you can write division is equals to bracket close plus c. This is your result, and you can see that whatever operation you have performed, you will get the result of that over here. Okay, so this is the answer, or this is the way how you can make a program using binary arithmetic operators. Clear everyone? Okay, now the next topic is ternary operators, or we can say conditional assignment. Ternary operator or conditional assignment. What is the use of ternary? A very good topic, and I think the starting of your program will be started today only, because ternary operator gives you a very good programming techniques to make the program. How? Now just see.
Let me write the copy. Ternary. Operator. Now the word ternary means it deals with three operands now. In unary, we are dealing with one operand. In binary, we are dealing with two operand. But in ternary, we are going to deal with three operands. How? Let's see. First of all, the syntax for this is what? You have to write a variable in which you are going to store the result. Then after that, the condition. The condition. Whatever condition you are having in your question, or it is also known as test expression. I am telling expression, not statement. Expression means there is no assignment of variable over there. And then there will be a question mark. There will be a question mark. After that, whatever the expression one, and then colon, after that expression two. This will be the syntax for your ternary operator. If I give an example for this syntax, then just see over here. Variable, any variable you can use. Suppose x I am using. Suppose you are going to check in A and B which number is greater. So just write down over here A greater than B. A greater than B. If A is greater, then A else B. This is the way by which we are going to write our statement. X is variable over here. You can just compare it like that. X is variable over here. Then A greater than B is the condition or test expression. A will be my expression 1 and B will be my expression 2. Okay, so this is the full explanation about ternary operator and their example. Now we will see any example for this to make it more easily understandable. Okay, suppose I take an example of your book only. If suppose one example is there. B is equals to, sorry, not B. If A greater than B, if A greater than B, then print what? B equals to B minus A. Okay? Else, close it. Else what? Again open. B equals to A minus B. Okay? And close. Yes, finish. This is the question we are having. If A greater than B, then B equals to B minus A. Else, otherwise, B equals to A minus B. Now you see one thing. Here we have to store result in B. This is my variable. Okay, wherever we have to store the result, we will take that one as a variable. Now see how I am making it. B is equals to, means this is my variable. B is equals to, this is my condition. Am I right? Yes. A greater than b. This is the condition. Then after that, question mark. If a greater than b, then result will be this. So we have to write this one first, b minus a. Otherwise, a minus b. So whatever will be the result over there, you will get that result. Now I am going to make program for this, for the same question. Okay, let's see the same question. I am going to make a program for this. Suppose there is one class and class name is ternary. Okay, then after that we have to write PSDL, and there is one method by which we can give the value at the time of execution, and this is known as main method. In main method, if we write int a int b, then at the time of execution it will ask the value which you want. When you are going to just execute this program at the time of void main, you are going to give the values for this. In class 8 we have taught you how to take value at the time of execution by putting value in main method. Okay, and if you are having any problem, there is no issue. You just go through the program, write the program as I am writing. Then after that, you just do the void main. In void main, you will get these two values that you have to type, and after that, click on OK. You will go through the terminal. Okay. Next. Now the next thing is what? We are having A and B as the value. Then after that, we have to store it in D. So take int b. Okay. Now afterwards, b is equals to, what was my condition? A greater than b. Okay. Question mark. B minus a or a minus b. This will be my situation. Now we have to print this one. Then what is the method? Same method. System dot out dot print ln, and in that we have to write what? First of all, write one statement. Result is equals to plus d, and just close all the brackets. The same way, whatever the way I have used over here, you will use it, you will get the desired result, whatever you want, whatever value you will give. If you will give a greater than b, then it will take this one. Suppose I am testing the condition. Suppose you have given a equals to 10 and b equals to 5. In that situation, what you will get? This part will execute because a greater than b, so this part will execute. Okay, so 5 minus 10. 5 minus 10, you will get minus 5 as a value. Because here a greater than b, and in a greater than b I said what? B minus a. And if you use like that, a equals to 10 and b equals to 15, in that condition a is not greater than b, so this situation will not execute, this one will execute, and you will get 10 minus 15 as the answer. That means minus 5 will be your answer in that situation. Okay, clear everyone? Good. So this is the class for ternary operator.
There are some examples given in your book. You just go through that examples, solve that examples, make program on it. Then you will be more familiar with this conditional programming. Okay. And if you are having any problem, we are having doubt clear in class as live classes. In that, you can ask any question regarding your problem. Okay. So till then, goodbye. Have a nice day. Thank you.